In Berlin, there's no strong municipalist movement running for elections at the moment. There are, however, very lively social movements on different topics. And so from some of these movements, activists have joined politics or administration, something we might call municipalist moments. And these social movements have very concrete demands on the municipal level concerning housing, health, education, labor, migration, or global justice or other topics, but these movements are very separate from each other. In some of the social movements, particularly in the housing movement, there is talk about municipalism, particularly after the success in Barcelona and after the Fearless City Conference in Barcelona in 2017. And municipalism is discussed in different events and among different circles of activists. And since maybe 1 year, approximately 20, a circle of 20 activists is meeting to discuss how municipalism could look like in Berlin, but at the moment it's rather a discussion than a practice. The idea is not running for elections with this municipalist platform, because the analysis is that the established parties here are not that delegitimized than in other cities, and another left election platform would further the scattering of the left vote. So this is something that the movements do not want to further. The idea is to establish rather different relationships between the existing parties, particularly the Left Party, the Green Party, and in some parts also the Social Democratic Party, and the social movements that already exist. The first step for a municipalist platform in Berlin is to bring together the scattered single issue movements, to bring them together, to talk to each other, to get to know each other, to understand what they are doing, and to establish a platform of shared practices and of shared understanding of how we want to do politics in the future and to what end, what kind of demands we have. The pandemic, of course, was a difficult situation for social movements because it made usual practices of social movements nearly impossible, and also because the debt taken on during the pandemic now will lead to further austerity measures in the future, which will make further action even more difficult. But the social movements could also celebrate some great successes during the victory. Just last week, the campaign to expropriate Deutsche Wohnen and other big landlords in Berlin could submit 350,000 signatures for a referendum for this expropriation. They collected the signatures in the last 4 months during the pandemic, when there were no big events, which shows the dedication of Berlin's population to stop the sellout of the city, and which also is, of course, a great starting point for a municipalist movement.